Chris Holworth, lead guitar player in this moment.
Jeff Babb, drummer in this moment.
Yeah, man.
And this is the first day of Mayhem Fest.
Well, immediately when we pulled up, we saw a bunch of people we knew. And everyone was like, hey, what's up, hey, what's up? So that's really cool to be on a tour where, like, you know, you just feel like you got friends and there's no weird vibes, you know, and it's just everyone's here to just have a good time and rock. And
I got one word for all that. Metal.
Metal.
Metal tour. That's the biggest difference between Warped Tour and this tour. And Jeff said it all. I mean, it's instantly like everyone's like, hey, bro, how's it going? Walking up, saying hello. I mean, we were on Warped Tour for 2 months straight and we only met a couple of bands. You know, it's just not the same kind of vibe.
Yay! Yay!
PT!
Introduce yourself.
Kyle Conkeel.
And?
The new bass player for this moment.
Yay!
So, Kyle, first big festival tour within this moment. What are you excited most about?
I'm excited about, like, really two things: to play in the shows in front of, like, you know, just amazing crowds, and, like, just watching all the cool bands I've been listening to since high school, you know, Lamb of God, Shadows Fall, Chimera, you know, Korn, Rob Zombie.
We've said it a bunch of times in the press that we do, but I think it's our defining album. I mean, because we kind of like the first album we had been writing all together, you know, and in the same room, and this is just, we had plenty of time leading up to it to write the songs, you know. It wasn't like we were like rushing to do an album. And with The Dream, we were in really experimental, kind of just searching for what we really are, and we realized, you know, we're a heavy band, we're a metal band, and that's part of us, and we just kind of mixed the two styles of In This Moment together on this album, so it's like defining who we are.
Yeah, it was all planned out, pretty much.
And so basically, hearing this song...
It was!
Metal album, rock album, metal rock album.
Impact on these crowds, and then the mindset was we're going on after Chimera or Shadows Fall, one or the other every day. You know, it's like we got to be on point with our heaviness in the song. So we picked a heavy set. You know, there's some, you know, melodic stuff, but we're mainly playing the new album and the first album. We're not really touching on The Dream on this one.
Singing that song, and
actually this is what's happening. The guy who sang the song on the record, Adrian Patrick, is going to be following the tour. Hopefully he's going to make every show. He'll definitely be here at the Moor tomorrow, but he's going to sing the song for every day, and hopefully that goes over good with the Mayhem crowd. It's a heavy song, you know, but it's also melodic, so we'll see, but people can expect to see a duet.
If tomatoes start flying, we got some other ones.
Yeah, we'll plot another song.
We got two refrigerators?
Two fridges, which is like a bonus, because most buses just have one crappy fridge. Try to keep those full of water. It's a nice, pretty nice bus. This thing gets a workout. Oh, it's a double Foreman.
I brought it on the last tour, but the single one wasn't big enough, so we got the two.
We had a burger assembly line going on this thing every night after the show.
Yeah.
And we're sharing the bus with Norma Jean on this tour, so Norma Jean has the front half of the bus, his first six bunks, and then In This Moment has this whole back area. You know, Jeff, this is my bunk. Got my shoes in there, you know. Installed a little fan, so I got extra air, because sometimes the AC just does not cut it, these things. Mm-hmm. And then I got to have my iPod. I got Velcro on the back of it, so I can put it on top or on the side. If I roll on my side, I can watch movies when I go to bed at night. Doesn't matter if the bus has got the DVD or not. I can just watch it on my iPod. And then you got to have a little charging station for your phone up in the corner there. You got a tape with a little extension cord and everything. I do my bunk up, so it's like, you know, the stuff is right in there. And then you got to bring a blanket from home and a pillow from home if you can. Sometimes I guess that happens, but not really. This bus is probably going to be pretty chilled. Uh-oh.
Hi.
We're coming into your to do an interview.
We're not doing an interview.
Introduce yourself. Say hi. Say hi to the fans.
Hello, everybody. I have no makeup.
We wanted you to be mean and slam the door in our face.
Yeah.
Get the fuck out of here. This is essential.
Aww.
Say hi.
She doesn't like us.
She doesn't know who you are. Who are these weird people? This is essentials. Candles, makeup, pillows, incense over there, and my good energy stones. I think that it's like this awesome, like, everybody's friends. Like, we got off the bus and everybody's saying hello and hugging each other, and there's just this really fun party summer atmosphere going on, and everyone's excited to go up in front of crowds and kick serious ass every day. We're gonna give it 100%. We're gonna play a bunch of new sick songs. I have new dresses and a sick new microphone stand. Did you see it?
We did.
Isn't that cool?
It's awesome.
Did you film it?
Did you get it?
It's so fun. Christopher Howarth helped me with that. I'll give him credit. And just that's it. Like, we were out there a little while ago, and Randy came up, and I was walking my dog, and he was petting her, and everybody's saying hello. He's all like, hey, great guys. So it's just like a bunch of friends and everybody hanging out and being happy, and it's all about fucking metal and rock and roll and having a good time and meeting the fans. And
going to Stop Track in a few then, right?
It's the party. Mayhem, baby.
We're going over to see our gear. Our Tech Brownie and Blake Winsell, the guitarist.
Other guitarist.
We're showing them our gear.
Alright, well, we gotta go up on stage.
Well, we're gonna show them our gear first.
No, they're calling for us right now.
They're calling for us. So look, this is Brownie working on our strings.
This is our guitars.
The Schecters are mine and Kyle's and Blake with Ernie Ball.
How many different tunings do you have for each?
It's retarded. We always do albums in different tunings, and we have actually four tunings on this set, on the Mayhem set, but we only switch guitars twice. We just have to tune to one string or something, you know, to change it. It's weird, I know. It's like such a pain in the ass. I would say people are going to be really surprised at them. I do think a lot of people on this tour probably don't know who we are, or are curious maybe, but you know, really aren't sure what we're all about. And we're just going to put on a good show and sound really good, and play good songs, man, and hopefully win these people over.